In Zoom Contact Center, flows determine the path an incoming engagement takes as it's routed to a particular destination, such as an automated menu, voicemail box, or queue. In this example, we'll walk through the process of creating a new flow as an admin. In the Zoom Admin portal, navigate to Contact Center Management. Click on Flows and select Add Flow. Input a channel source type from the drop-down menu. In this case, I'm creating a flow to support calls that come into a main support line, so I'll choose Voice. If I were creating a flow with a video entry point, such as a Zoom kiosk, or a messaging entry point, such as Zoom Virtual Agent, I would choose one of those options here instead. Next, add a name for the flow. And optionally, add a description. Selecting Add saves a draft of the new flow shell to your contact center and opens a new browser tab containing the flow editor. The flow editor is a drag and drop interface for admins to configure flow widgets and make connections between them. The widgets and connections work together to set a path for inbound engagements. Using the flow editor is similar to using a digital whiteboard. While creating your flow, you can drag and drop widgets onto the flow canvas, click and drag the canvas to position your view, access buttons to undo and redo recent actions, zoom in and out, and view the version history for the flow you're working in. Selecting any widget on the canvas reveals a configuration panel with additional information and settings specific to that widget type. With my start widget already on the canvas, I can begin to add and connect additional widgets to create my flow. Recall, in this case, my goal is to route customer voice calls coming into the company support line to a queue of support agents. I'd like all customers calling the support line to hear a recorded audio message as their first greeting. To achieve that, I'll drop in the Send Media widget, optionally rename it, and either choose an audio file from the asset library or enter text to be spoken by a digitally generated voice. I can preview the audio message.
Thank you for calling Zoomly Hughes support. An agent will be with you momentarily.
And click back on the canvas to minimize the configuration panel when I'm done. Note that while my support greeting is now on the canvas, it is not yet connected to the Start widget. To make this connection, I can click on the Start widget, select the Exits tab, and choose Support Greeting from the drop-down field. A connection line immediately appears, indicating that these widgets are now connected in my flow. After hearing the greeting, I'd like callers to be connected to the first available agent in the company support queue. To achieve that, I'll drop in the Route To widget and rename it to something more descriptive. Under the Settings tab, select Queue under the Route To dropdown, and then choose the intended queue for this flow. In this case, I've already created a queue of support agents to add. After selecting the queue, I can view details specific to it by scrolling down the info panel. If I'd like to update any of these settings, for example, routing priorities, I can do so by visiting the Queue Management section of the admin portal. Next, I can click back to my flow canvas and connect my previous widget to this one by selecting it in the Exits Next Step dropdown. Lastly, I'll drop in one final Route To widget to configure this flow to disconnect the call when either the agent or the customer hangs up. After dropping in and renaming my final Route To widget, I'll select Disconnect under the Route To dropdown. Then I'll click back to the flow canvas, select my support queue widget, and in the Exits Call Finished dropdown, I'll select the name of the Route 2 Disconnect widget I just added. With my widgets configured, I can save and then publish this flow. From the main Flows page, I can now see its status as published, along with its description, channel type, and entry points. Note that the entry point for this flow, the main company support line phone number, is not yet listed here. As a final step to putting this flow into action, I can select phone numbers under Contact Center Management, choose the Unassigned tab, find the phone number associated with the main support line, and select the three dots at the end of its row. Then I can choose Manage Flows and assign this number to the flow we previously created and published. With my widget set and version published, this flow is ready to handle engagements. If I'd like to update it or any of my other flows in the future, I can navigate back to Flows under Contact Center Management and click on the name of any flow to access its Flow Editor page. With that, we've successfully created and configured a new flow in Zoom Contact Center. Way to go! With the flow. Sorry, it was right there.